We shall now write the new user form. We are following the approach of creating all the forms first. We are not coding it at present. We are writing the HTML for the new user form and for the forgot password form. And then we'll proceed to the coding part. Before proceeding further, let us revise what we have done. This is our startup view. That is presented when the user logs into your opens your website. There is a simple login. This one action link that takes the user to login area and runs the index action inside the controller. Once we are into the area called login area, we have a controller for index new user. We already added these action methods, new user, forgot password, and we have added probably only one view for the new user, which is empty. I find that I should then we also have added the index, the login page, and we added at the footer two link buttons, one for forgot password and one for new user. The second arguments are the action methods. This is the login page basically. Username, text box for validation message, submit. Then new user, title of the link button, forgot password is the title of the link button here. This link button points to the action method called new user, and this one points to the action method called forgot password. We have already added the two action methods in our user controller. In the last lecture, we added a view also to the new user. We can have a look at the view also. New user.cshtml. This is the new user, but we haven't still added forgot password view for forgot password. Let us add that also so that things come parallel. Click add. Now let us run it and see at what stage we are at present. User clicks on the login. He is taken to a form where neither your these validations work. Click on new user. He is taken to the new user page. Click on forgot password. He is immediately taken to the forgot password page. This means at least the navigation is complete. Now we should write the HTML for the new user first. This is our new user page. We can start writing directly. What will be the model? Let us add that model first. @model. Write the complete path. This is the namespace that I am having, TBL user. This is the model on which we operate. Then we have @ using HTML dot begin form. Here we can write the table story for that. So this is the form that we have quickly keyed out. Email, text box, validation message, Similarly, phone prompt, text box for phone, validation message for phone, then a submit button having create user written on it. Side by side, we can also place the navigation bar below it that takes us to your new back to login and forgot password story. I'm just copying it quickly, pasting it here, doctoring it out. We are on the new user page, so this must be replaced by back to login, and the login is index. Now let us run and see, at least our form should be in place. Login. New user should be in place. Yes, it is in place. Nothing is firing. Back to login is working. Coming back to new user, forgot password. It is to be made. We'll create the forget password one also right now, so that at least we bring everything to one common level. So this is our forgot password CSHTML. Here we can begin to write @using. So we can type it quickly. At the top, we have added the model for the TBL user. @using HTML.beginForm. This will be the email. The user will enter his email and then click on the button called get password. And finally, at the bottom, we have the action links for back to login and new user. We can now verify that this one indeed works. Login, forgot password, no validations work, new user, this is working, back to login, new user, forgot password, back to login. This means our circuit is complete. So this is how it works. If you want me to summarize, here is what my summary point would be. Process of adding a new page. If you are from ASP.NET background, you must be very accustomed to the drag and drop story. But in the case of MVC, the process is, it's up to you how you think. But personally, I find the process to be too simple. You have to just add an action method, then right click somewhere inside it and add view. That is how you add a new page to an MVC application. Okay, right now our circuit is complete, and next we'll work on the validation part so that validation start working before we finally run to the coding part. Thanks.